Hi, and welcome to This is Marketecture. Today I'm joined by Ruggero from Docebo.
Thank you, Fabio, for having me.
It's a pleasure. So, Ruggero, could you tell us a little bit more about Docebo?
Sure. So, Docebo produces AI-powered learning e-learning tools, and within Docebo, I worked in the Shape team.
Okay, so this Shape team, what do you do for Docebo? What's your project, your goal?
Yes, so Shape aims to produce e-learning pills starting from complex documents like business processes or scientific papers or marketing presentations. And it aims to produce an e-learning pill of about 5 minutes, roughly.
Okay, so what do you do with these documents?
Yeah, so our main goal is to reduce the noise from the document, and because we don't want really to provide information that are not helpful in the e-learning journey of the final user. And right now we are dealing with about 10 to 20 documents a day, and this specific architecture is able to handle about 30 to 50 pages per minute.
Oh, okay. So these are the numbers. So let's get into the technological details. How does this work?
Sure. So first of all, there are some files.
Okay. So these are the ones provided by the end users. And these are PDFs?
Yeah, mainly like PDFs.
Okay. Text and images.
Text and images. So rich files that the user uploads, and we store them into an S3 bucket. Once the files are uploaded and stored into S3, we send events through the main bus with the reference to those files. And every event triggers a step function powered by Lambda functions. And the first step we do is to convert each page into an image, just to be able to analyze the image with a custom machine learning model that is deployed into a SageMaker real-time endpoint. Once we analyze the layout of the page, we do some text extraction using a managed text struct API. And once we have the text, we do some post-processing, like figuring the reading order or more semantic analysis. And then once the document is ready and we figure out whether there is noise and where the noise is, we can send them back. We can send events back through the main bus just to notify that the process is ready.
So in essence, you have many lambdas, you go through different phases, and then whatever you prepare would be an input for other part of Docebo.
Exactly.
To work on the documents and have them clean in some kind of way. Okay, good. Is there any metrics that you could share about how good you are treating the documents?
Yeah, sure. So as I was saying before, the main challenge is to be able to reduce the noise in the final output. Okay. And in that sense, we managed to reduce the noise by about 80% with this specific architecture.
So that's very good. So that means that you remove stuff and the other teams will not have to work on that stuff, which is not meaningful to your customer. Okay, nice. So I got an overview. Is there any area in the architecture where you learned something or that you changed over time because it was not working the way you wanted?
Yeah, so the Shape team had never deployed a custom machine learning model into production. And in that regard, SageMaker was really helpful, not only for the deploying phase, but also helpful in helping us to manage the scaling part of the infrastructure. And a natural evolution of this architecture could be using a SageMaker serverless endpoint instead of the real-time endpoint.
Okay, so you want that to be something like pay-per-use?
Yeah, sure, just to cut on costs.
Yeah, because the whole infrastructure is serverless. This is the only endpoint that is sitting there 24/7.
Yeah.
So yeah, that really makes sense. No, it's a very compelling architecture. Thank you very much for sharing that, Ruggero.
Thank you for having me again.
And thank you for watching. This is my architecture.